Gentlemen, welcome.
Good afternoon.
So who do I begin with? I'll begin with the one with the first letter of the alphabet. Is that okay?
That's good.
Is that okay?
Sure. That's good. All that's right. Me.
So your share price yesterday, that's why I got to begin, took a hit yesterday. Today, it continues to be under pressure. I think we're looking at 9.9% at the moment. And I asked an analyst that I had in studio with me here why the stock was taking so much punishment. And one of the issues he raised was sell C. So let's begin at sell C. Can you explain, in terms of the impact in this set of results, what went wrong on sell C?
You know, I think that's really the right place to start, because I think the whole market is judging Blue Label currently only on sell C, and not quite sure what they're judging us on as the inference of what we've done wrong or done right, not quite sure where it's coming from.
How long have you had sell C now?
We've 8 months.
Right.
So the restructure took place in August of last year. And internally, all our budgets, all our plans, we're actually ahead of schedule. So I think the next 2 or 3 days is extremely important for us to engage with the market, to actually understand where they believe we've gone wrong or where they believe sell C has gone wrong. But quite frankly, you know, sell C for us is a growth story. It was a huge restructure and recapitalization in August of last year. Mm-hmm. We injected 5.5 billion rand for 45%, which of course is a huge number. Sure. And we need our time to put it out, to make this growth story happen. It's about the next year or two. And as far as we're concerned, we're right on track. And I think it's about relaying the message to the market that I don't think we have disappointed, because I'm not quite sure what we're measuring against, to
sure.
be honest.
So one of the issues, too, actually, that the analyst I was talking about spoke about is, and I asked him, I said to him, I've got the two CEOs coming through to the studio. Please give me a question to ask them. And he said to me, Godfrey, two things. One, costs. And secondly, efficiencies within the business. Can you address those?
Oh, sorry, we're referring to
sell C still, yes.
So, you know, if you look at all the markers that we've presented, all the markers are up. I think if you have a look at the numbers in more granular detail, which sell C will present them next week, you'll see there's massive cost containment, eliminating any leakage. So I think the market is more concerned on CapEx, and maybe he's referring to cost being, how do they maintain this CapEx rollout?
Yes.
And, you know, the message to the market is simple. Cell C is not another me. They're not designed or don't want to compete with a Vodacom and MTN. Mm. They really got their own strategy revolving around there is megs and minutes. But they're in the MVNO space, they're in the fiber to home space, they're in the content space. So they're not placed as another me. And I think that's where the market is missing, because there's nothing really else to compare it to in this marketplace.
Right.
So the cost for me is quite interesting. I think they're referring to CapEx. And, you know, the question we're facing all the time.
And the change in technology, obviously. So one of the things referred to was the movement from 3G, 4G, 5G. Who knows how many other Gs we're going to add in the near future, and the cost of it.
So part of that migration is this new roaming or capacity sharing deal with MTN, which allows him now access into the 4G market, which they never had in the agreement with Vodacom, and the seamless handover of it. So they've been smart at using what they have and the tools available to them, utilizing the cash available to them, in terms of, we said to the market, between 2.5 and 3 billion rand will be spent on CapEx. They're never going to have a CapEx run rate like a Vodacom or MTN, because that's not where they're trying to play.
Absolutely. At the risk of concentrating too much on sales here, I just wanted to ask one more question. The issue of regulatory and the environment. We know that the regulators are saying prices need to come down, and prices need to come down on data in particular, and there are these other issues that they raised. I just want to make a little point about sales here. If I'm correct, I think it's the only mobile phone network provider that continues to allow the depletion of your airtime from your data without warning you that you are running into your airtime, which is hugely frustrating. I'm a customer, that's why I'm speaking like this. To what extent will you be able to get a handle on that, and then obviously deal with the regulatory pressures?
So I think, just to deal with the regulator to start, I think Cell C engages with the regulator all the time. You know, as one of the minnows in a telco's industry, we embrace change, and I think that there needs to be a lot of change in the telco's industry. So we will keep on engaging with the regulator on a day-to-day basis. And where we can, we'll obviously help and be a part of change, because change needs to take place. So you definitely don't have a network that is against the regulator. You have a network that's working definitely with the regulator.
Yeah.
As far as certain things go in certain customer experiences, I think that's how networks and that's how companies improve all the time. And you know, feedback, like what you're saying, is something that, oh, well, it's live on TV, so I'm sure it's already got back there, right? But it's something that, of course, that we will take back. But I think these are things you have to continuously improve on. You know, data must come down. That's where the regulator and government has to play a part. It's not just the networks that can help that come down. And data bundles not expiring and all these things that I'm talking about, they will come into being and they will happen. Cell C will embrace them, and where we can fix efficiencies and fix problems for customer experience, we definitely want to. What differentiates us amongst many things is actually service. Sure. If we're not going to give a great service and we're not going to be that to the consumer, it's one of the things that's low-hanging fruit for us.
So in this set of results, one of the big things that I noticed is that a huge amount of money that you guys spend on acquisitions. I think 7.5, 7.6 billion rand.
Correct.
So I imagine there's a lot of there's going to be a lot of chewing, if you like, to consolidate these businesses going forward. Just in terms of what you are doing on that front, just give me a quick sense of where you're taking that and when you begin to see the benefits coming through. I don't know who to ask.
So from an acquisition part, I think people need to understand Blue Label doesn't do acquisitions for the sake of it. They're very calculated, very strategic by nature, and how we're going to use them in our broader business. So, you know, at the latter part of last year, we did Cell C, we did 3G, and we did AirVantage. The focus on this year is embedding those businesses into Blue Label to ensure that there's strategic alignment, to ensure vertical integration, better efficiencies, better economies of scale. So. Yeah, the acquisitions were done not only for what they're doing in the existing form factor when we bought them, but how we could leverage off that RP into our base and actually extrapolate our pound of flesh in what we want to do with those businesses.
Absolutely. So we've run out of time, but quick point from you in terms of what the market needs to understand about CLC and what you guys are trying to do with it.
I think in a nutshell is the game plan, that this is 8-month-old business, not a 15-year-old business, and that they need to understand the vision and strategy, and it's clear, and we know exactly what we want to do, and give us the time to implement and prove the market wrong.
Absolutely. Gentlemen, thank you for coming
through. Thank you, Godfrey.
Thank you.
That's the brothers, Mark and Brett Levy, the joint CEOs of Blue Label Telecommunications.